3 factorial equals 3 plus 2 plus 1. Well, no, but actually, yes. Let's talk about it. I'll tell you, this is just one of the beautiful coincidences in math. Let's talk about factorial first. So, in general, if you have n factorial, here n has to be a positive whole number. In that case, you can break it down as n times 1 less than that, so n minus 1, and then times n minus 2, so on, up to 1, and then you're done, right? So for example, if today you have, let's say, 5 factorial, this just means 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. You can work that out, you will get 120. 4 factorial means 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, and you will get 24. And then 3 factorial, technically it should be 3 times 2 times 1, and if you work that out, you get 6. But the beauty for this one right here is that if you add 3 plus 2 plus 1, that's also going to be 6, right? Just a nice coincidence. This thing does not look right if you put 4 factorial, because if you do it as 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1, 7 plus 2 is 9 plus 1 is 10. Of course, these are not equal anymore, but this were equal earlier. And of course, you can also do the 5. 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1, that's just 15. And of course, they are not equal. Yeah, so it only works for 3 factorial, because if you try another one, 2 factorial, this means 2 times 1, which is 2. But if you try this right here, this is 2 plus 1, which is 3. In fact, for this right here, it also has a name. This is called the triangular number. Meanwhile, this right here, it was called the factorial. And then in this video, our n value is just positive whole number, 1, 2, 3, so on, right? And in fact, for the triangular number, what you do is just like n, and then you plus the next n value, what, 1 less than that, so it's n minus 1, and then you add the next one, n minus 2, so on, up to 2 and 1. If you do this, unfortunately, we don't have a nice notation, not like as cool as that, but we actually have a much better formula, because this right here will give you n times n plus 1 over 2. That's the formula for the triangular number. So you guys can check out my other video on why this formula is true. I think, yeah, it's pretty cool. Now, in this video, let's also talk about what if you keep on going with the factorial. If you do 1 factorial, this is just going to be 1, done, right? Here's a nice pattern, though. If you go to 0 factorial, what's the answer for that? If you look at the right-hand side here, from 120 to 24, you divide it by 5. From 24 to 6, you divide it by 4. From 6 to 2, you divide it by 3. What's the pattern? We divide it by 5, divide it by 4, divide it by 3, so we will have to divide it by 2, so we will have to divide it by 1. So I mean 0 factorial is just going to give you 1, which is one of the surprising things in math, I would say. Yeah, because it doesn't look right, but you have to kind of follow the pattern. Of course, there are other explanations, but I think this is the most intuitive way to understand why 0 factorial should be equal to 1.